Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Today we have a topic with us, it's called open market operations. Now, what exactly this is all about? See, this is the strategy that is adopted by the central bank, let it be RBI or Fed. You know, they do it to regulate the economy as a whole. We'll try and understand this in a very detailed format. Let's begin on this. First and the foremost thing that we are going to start is, what is the open market operations? Right. See, the open market operation is a monetary policy. Okay. It's a tool that is used by the central bank of the country to either increase or decrease the money supply in the economy by the sale or the purchase of government security. Now, there are some steps that there are some steps of OMO operations. The central bank, you know, takes either the following, you know, two main steps based on the economic condition, which are known to be known as the open market operations. The first one is buying government from banks, and second is selling government bonds to bank. Here it's bonds. Okay, so these are the two ways. Okay. Let's discuss this. First, buying GOV, government bonds, from the banks. We'll try and discuss this. See, when the central bank of the country buys government bonds, the economy is usually in the recessionary condition. Okay, that is in the recessionary gap phase, with unemployment being a big tick problem. So when the central bank buys government bonds, it increases the money supply in the economy. The increased money supply, that is MS, is going to increase. The increase in the money supply decreases the interest rate, that is the I will decrease, and the decrease in the interest rate causes the consumption and the investment, that is the C and the I, the consumption and the investment spending will increase. And hence, the aggregate demand will also increase. Now, increase in the aggregate demand causes a real GDP to rise. So, this buying government bonds from banks increases the real GDP of the economy. And hence, the method is called the expansionary monetary policy. Let's discuss the second part. Now, the central bank sells government bonds to banks when the economy is facing inflation. So, the central bank tries to control the inflation by selling the bonds to bank. Okay. Now, when government bonds are sold by the central bank, it sucks the excess money from the economy. So, this causes a decrease in the monetary supply, a decreased monetary supply. Okay. Now, a decreased monetary supply causes and, you know, interest rates, that is I, to increase. And increased interest rate causes the consumption and the investment spending to fall, absolutely. And thus, the aggregate demand will also fall. And thus, a decrease in the aggregate demand causes the real GDP to fall. I hope you have got a fantastic idea about this two method. See, thus selling government bonds to bank decreases the real GDP of the economy, and hence this method is called contractionary monetary policy. Okay, fine. Second, let's discuss the types of OMO, open market operations. See, there are two types of open market operation. The permanent OMO, and the second is the temp OMO. Well, when we talk about the permanent OMO, it this is involved in outright buying and selling of government securities, government SEC, and such an operation is taken to have long-term benefit, like, you know, inflation, you have unemployment, okay, accommodating the trend of the currency in the circulation. And if you talk about the temp OMO, this is usually done for the reserve requirement that are transitory in nature, or to provide, you know, you can say money in short term. So such an operation is done using either repo or reverse repo. So a repo is an agreement by which a trading desk buys security from the central bank with a promise to sell, with a promise to sell in the future at a later date. And it can also be considered as a short-term collateralized loan by central bank, with the difference in the purchase price and the selling price as interest on the security. Now, under a reverse repo, the trading desk sells security to the central bank. It's reverse. B bank sells to the central bank with an agreement to buy at a future date. So overnight repos and reverse repos are used for such temporary OMOs. Now, I'll take you to the example part. Now, let's understand the OMO operation example with the help of one more example. The Fed, the Federal Reserve Bank, that's the central bank of the United States, it purchased 175 million MBS, that is mortgage-backed securities, from banks that had been originated by Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac. All know majorly this mortgage giants and the Federal Home Loan Banks. So between January 2009 and August 2010, it also bought $1.25 trillion in MBS, that is mortgage-backed security that had been guaranteed by Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, and Ginnie Mae. So between 2009 to, that's March 2009 to October 2009, it had purchased closely around $300 billion of long-term, we can say that, treasuries from the member banks. So as the Fed's short-term treasury bills matured, it used the proceeds to buy the long-term, you know, we can say that treasury notes to keep the interest rates down, and it continued to buy the MBS with the proceeds of MBS that matured. Now, I want you to discuss what exactly are the advantage of, you know, of OMO. See, first is that the inflation and the interest rates are targeted here. So the major target of the operation is interest rates and inflation. So the central tries to maintain the inflation at certain range so that the economy of the country grows at a stable and steady pace. Now, this is taken by central bank, which has a close relation with the interest rates. So when the central bank offers securities and government bonds to other banks and the public, it will affect the supply and demand of credit as well. Now, second, the buyers of the bond deposit the money from their account to central bank's account, and thereby, you know, they decrease their own reserve. Okay, so with the commercial banks buying such securities, they will have less money to lend to the general public, and thus reducing the credit creation capacity, which impact the supply of the credit. Now, when the central bank sells the security, there is a decrease in the price of the bond. Okay, there is a decrease in the price of the bond and the interest rates, which is going to be inverse of that always. So price is going to decrease and the interest rate is going to increase, right? And there is a decrease in the demand of credit. So you can say the demand credit will decrease here. So with the decrease in the supply and the demand for the credit due to less reserves, high interest rates, consumption reduces at reducing the inflation. So when the central bank buys securities, the cycle is reversed and the inflation rises and interest rates decreases. And second is the monetary money supply targeting. Right, so the central bank may target the control of the money supply in the economy, and the central bank tries to maintain adequate liquidity in the banking system. And when it feels that there is a high liquidity, it tries to suck the excess liquidity by selling bonds and vice versa the case. So, let me put my words on the final conclusion notes. See, OMO operations are the central bank's monetary policy tool to maintain the inflation, interest rates, money supply, and liquidity in the economy. So central bank can buy or sell securities under such operations depending on the economic conditions. There are some permanent measures are generally taken to target the inflation and the interest rates for the short-term duration, and while temp measures are taken generally to check the liquidity in the system of the near-term duration. So depending on whether the general public buys or sells securities, it impacts the general public and business houses, as the loans may get costlier or cheaper respectively.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.